eats the books.
Mm-hmm. Eat the producers. So mostly a consumer is whatever eats the producers.
Doing photosynthesis came from blank molecules. A, carbon dioxide.
Do you think, you know, you would know what the pictures are?
Solar panels.
Sometimes it's good for students to hear from a different voice in the classroom.
So after these rocks are like broken down.
Especially when it's not all that different from their own voice.
What I thought was special is that not an adult was teaching us, but a teenager.
Okay, so let's write down renewable energy sources.
So they kind of know like what we feel like.
Eighth graders from Wilkinson Middle School.
How a food chain looks.
Taught science to fifth graders at Hanby Elementary.
They told us we were their favorite group.
On this unique day, eight different classrooms were filled with a different kind of learning.
This test is mainly going to be what y'all just learned today, right?
It's interesting to see how the fifth graders are responding.
We talked about these.
They are staring at them. They're looking for stuff. They want to sit by them. They want to get the answers right. It's just different coming from an eighth grader than it is a teacher sometimes.
The kids were really listening. The older kids were, of course, the professional. But I just seemed to me like there was, they engaged with them.
We're going to take all these cards and we're going to put them. We're going to put them where they need to go.
I think that just forming that relationship with them, even for just an hour, I mean, these kids love them.
Wilkinson science teacher Chris Camacho came up with this idea, which included not giving his students much of an idea about how to teach a class.
Oh, predator and prey for 500.
And that's the beauty of not giving a rubric. You never know what you're going to get.
Where are the producers in the food web?
And so we had Jeopardy today. We had yarn activities. They did things I was not expecting. Dances, singing.
Weathering. Breaking down the rocks.
What's nice about it is it's all based on what the teacher is attempting to do, not something directed to the teacher to do. And so it will gain legs, if you will, based on the excitement that it generates.
And becoming another population or see.
This wasn't just a teaching opportunity for the eighth graders. It was a learning opportunity, both about the subject matter and about being a teacher.
This process is called photosynthesis. It's a harder job than it looks like because you have to explain it well, and if the kids don't understand, then they have to rethink about it, and sometimes things don't go planned.
Kind of like the frogs.
We thought about what we learned in fifth grade and how it was taught to us. And we put together a project that, you know, they'll remember for, you know, most of their life. Wind energy, it uses the wind turbines.
It was a good day for learning, for everyone. The fifth graders learned things they didn't know.
We learned alternative energy. It was hard, but I kind of understand it.
This happens daily.
The eighth graders learned about preparation and execution, as well as adapting on the fly.
All right, I'm going to help y'all out.
And this teacher learned what is resonating with his own students when he is instructing them.
Think of the best lesson you ever had. What are the things that you like to see? So I'm able to get some really good feedback for myself of, hey, this is the type of teaching they like.
What a fossil fuel really is?
And that mold inside has a bacteria.
Any questions?